here's the idea. I don't want to fight these both at the same time. I just want to fight this particular army right here. And to do so, I'm going to have to try and spring the ambush, but with some backup. So I'm going to put them right here, and they're not going to take the ambush, actually, because of the reinforcements that I have. It's disadvantageous to them. So now I'm going to move these guys right here. And nope, they still haven't sprung. And so then I'm going to move this force right here. The same reason. So now what I'm going to do is now I'm going to have a big combined force at arms fight. And so reinforcements are going to be used on both sides. So let's see here. I'm going to... Well, we might as well use this main army here. Richard Fitzgilbert, a lord, is going to attack Elfgar and Thurkill. So,
moving to
let's
engage
do that.
The enemy.
So, once again, I have 3 reinforcements. My strength is 20 to 9, which is quite an interesting ratio. Once again, I will have AI reinforcements, just because, my goodness, it would just be insane for me trying to control them all. So I'll see you on the battle mat. Alright, so here's my formation. It's my archers are in the front row, with the second row of armored spearmen. On either wing, I have units of armored axemen, and then these foot knights, which are pretty badass looking. That's obviously on the other wing, and then also on either wing I have a unit of light cavalry, and then heavy cavalry. And then finally, just in the center, to act as a morale support, I have my clerics, the ones who don't want to spill blood, but they'll still bash in the brains of their enemy, and of course my general's bodyguard, and my general, who's right there. Alright, so let's start this battle. And looks like they have perched themselves right at the top of this hill, which is wise and incredibly frustrating. So, I'm going to have to think of how to get around them. Let's see what they have here. I can't really tell by their unit descriptives, but I'll just take a quick look at them. I do see some peasants and some birdmen. I can tell that much. But so they're not heavily armored, of course, with the exception of these Hulfskarls, which are definitely back here. Oh, and they have some bowmen as well as a change. Huh. Very interesting. So what I think I'm going to do is advance up with my infantry to about, we'll say about here for right now. And then in the meantime, I'm going to circle around with my cavalry and see if I can't prod their lines open for some sort of prod their lines for some sort of opening. There we are. Alright, I'll get back to you. So right now it looks like they're shifting towards the left for whatever reason, so I've moved my infantry back to a different direction right here to take advantage of that. And I'm going to just move my cavalry on this wing back a little bit. We're going to try to bring them back to about hereabouts. And these ones, however, who are making a wild circling and movement to move a little bit closer forward now, up to the top of this hill. And I'm swinging my cavalry even further back behind them. They're kind of just clustering in a giant heap. It looks like they're trying to take the protection of the woods here, which is actually would be very, very wise. But they're also in quite a bit of disarray as well, so I'm going to try to strike as fast as possible. So, looks like my units have gotten here in time, so let's bring them up a little bit more within archer range. And in the meantime, let's see what I can do with my cavalry here. Okay, so we have mercenary Litzthemen, which are they, and these are some peasants. And the Feardmen, peasants, Lightfird, Fird and Feared. It's that darn Y, it makes me think it should be pronounced differently. There's the Royal Hulfskarls. Okay, I know what I'll do. I'll bring up my light infantry here to kind of make them all nervous-like. But I'm going to bring in my heavy cavalry right about here. I'm going to put them on fire at will and see if we can't knock off a few of these Hulfskarls. Hulfskarls. There we are. Oh, it looks like they're coming down to meet me, so I'm going to stop. Oh, yes, it looks like they're charging. Oh, oh, maybe not. Oh, yeah, it does. Okay, excellent. Well then, oh, these guys have gotten engaged as well. Oh, with some peasants. Alright, well, let's just scatter them then. With a quick charge. Here, we'll take a quick, close look at that. Very either broken. We'll let my light infantry clean them up. Well, let's bring out my Norse cavalry there. Now, where are these guys? These guys need to get into position as well. More peasants. Okay, let's bring these guys right here. And these guys to take care of these peasants. Now we have to deal with this main charge. Wow. Significant. Impressive. Alright, so these guys Well, these guys aren't in position. Anyways, my archers are at skirmishing position, so I'm going to just bring up my axemen a little bit here and get set for a charge. I'm going to put these guys on guard mode to accept the charge. Okay, so their Ferdmen are hurling some light weapons. So to diminish that capacity, I'm going to charge in my right flank here of my axemen, who should make short work of them, hopefully. What do we have going up here? Select Ferd. Alright, the peasants. Let's see here, bring up my cavalry there. Let's see what my rest of my cavalry here is doing. Not very much yet. Ferdmen, light cavalry. Okay. Let's bring these guys up, like so, so they can do a charge around the hill. We'll try that. Now, my archers are soaking up the Ferdman's missiles, which is actually kind of perfect. We're going to just bring up my own axemen here, spread them out a little bit, so they can deal with what's coming along this way. Alright, so it looks like they're skirmishing backwards. So we're going to do the same thing as before. We're going to just lengthen them up and do that. Oh! Spoke too soon. So the Royal Housecarls are making their presence known. So let's meet them, and I'm going to bring up my own knights to also meet them there. And we're going to press everything forward now. We're going to do this. And we'll hold off. We'll just refuse my left flank right now. Now I'm going to bring up my general right here. Alright, let's just take a look at this. Axemen versus Royal Huscarls. Alright, well, this is a time when I could really use some cavalry. Now, they're being distracted right now. I mean, not my cavalry, but the enemy there is being distracted. So let's... Are they moving towards? No, they're not. But these Ferdmen are awfully exposed. Heavy cavalry! Attack! So let's see if we can't charge into them. Now, what's the rest of my cavalry looking like? Select Ferd. Now, where are my... Now, they're just handling them right there. Let's just redeploy my cavalry right here right now. Okay. So now these spearmen are also engaging. Light Ferd are dealing with my armored axemen. I'm going to try and punch through their right flank and circle around to try to hit the Royal Housecarls from the rear. In the meantime, I'm going to continue to push these men back by pressing forward with disadvantage. And we're going to press forward here as well. There we are. Okay, so now the majority of the enemy forces are coming along the left flank, so we're going to just refuse this section of the left right there. These guys are going to continue upwards. Now, what's going on? So my light infantry looks like they got caught and are routing. I'm going to bring out my knights, and we're going to swing them, retreat them back into the wood there. And what are these knights doing? Nothing right now. Let's see, should I try sneak some, you know, I'm going to try sneak some knights in through here, while these ones continue to distract the enemy. Yeah, I'm going to try sneak them through, hit these Royal House Garls from behind. I think that would be perfect. Now, let's just quickly check, though, while I'm doing this maneuver. Let's check how I'm doing here. Seems like there's certain of victory, which I find perplexing. Oh! What? Where did these House Carls come from? My goodness, well that's not good. Well, let's just, let's see here. What we're going to do is we're going to get ready for a charge here. And move up these clerics to bash in some House Carl's skull. Now, what's going on here? How am I doing? They're shaking. Okay, we're going to try to retreat them right here. Now, how's this cavalry doing? Oh, I think they might be able to make it. Come on. Okay, charge there. Yep, alright, next. Now we're going to have these guys charge. Okay, withdraw my general. Charging these clerics. Oh no, this charge got interrupted. Okay. Oh dear. This is quite the match. Alright, so we're going to send in my armored men here to assist them. I'm going to withdraw this cavalry. Oh dear. These armored axemen are routing now. That's not good at all. Where's my light cavalry? Light third are bothering them. This light cavalry also has reformed. I'm gonna bring them out this way. Now, where did my other Norman knights go? They're all the way over here. Let's see if they can't come in and save the day. Well, let's smash them into these peasants at least. And we will repeat with the charge against these House Carls. Alright, so the Royal House Carls are in serious trouble, so we're going to keep these armored spearmen up against them. I'm going to actually take them off of defensive guard mode so they can assist here. Now, this is a big, big cluster, a big mess, and if I can break it, I'll be in really good shape. So we're going to do something a little daring. We're going to bring up these knights and try to do a rear charge from them. Okay. Let's try to bring them over this way and do a charge in this direction instead. There we are. We'll give her a shot right there. Just take a look. Alright, so that may have caused a mass rout. Let's take a look. These peasants are routing. Peasants are routing. Broken. Yeah, that did something significant.